That's not done, and I don't believe there's a need for that, given that the board is we're discussing the substance of the motion. So simply a housekeeping item. 103.02 deals with the chairman's authority to unilaterally appoint members to serve on various committees. That will be modified to make it a simple majority vote, which is again consistent with how we do things in the county. If you'll go with me to page 8. That pertains to the agenda, and it provides that board members who place items on the agenda are encouraged to provide documentation to the clerk by the cutoff time, as opposed to being manual. Simply, again, to square with our practice. Sometimes board members get it to the clerk on time, and sometimes they don't. So you'll go with me to page 10. 107.05 actually deals with how zonings are handled. That does not include the rules that is already addressed by the Unified Development Code and is simply redundant. And quite frankly, it does not need to be in the rules. 108.01, we change the language with respect to work session items that become binding from being declared time critical. We never use that language. We say time sensitive, so we're simply making the language fit with the practice of the board. 108.02 pertains to how you actually take a vote. As you know, out here, you take it by push light panel. In the work session, you take it by verbal pronouncement. We did not have that in there. It actually said by raised hands. We don't use raised hands. We use verbal pronouncement. If you'll go with me to page 14, very quickly, we're almost done. This is the commissioner comment period. As you know, every commissioner has an opportunity to make a comment during the regular session. Some of the commissioners that have expressed an interest in having the same right in work session, this would authorize you to make a public comment of your own right in a work session. If you'll go with me to page 18. Two procedural items. One was to limit discussion, and one was to call the question. Both of them fairly significant procedural items meant to typically end debate. Historically, they required a 4/5 vote. The recommendation was to have a simple majority be able to either limit debate or call. Finally, if you go with me to page 24, the last modification was how you actually change these rules mid-year. Historically, it's required a 4/5 majority to change and modify the rules other than the first meeting of the year. This would modify it such that a simple majority of the board can modify the rules mid-year. Mr. Chairman, that is all the proposed modifications. The Board of Commissioners, if you are so inclined, could either approve them en masse, in other words, all of the red lines right now, or you could go through and decide if you want to throw some out or keep some. That's up to you. Council?
What's the pleasure of the board?
Just one question on the comment section you spoke of.
Yes, sir.
Is that going to be listed on the agenda, similar to announcements and reports listed on our agenda on work session agendas?
You know, I don't know that it was thought through with quite that specificity. I think the concern was just a couple of times in the last year a board member did want to make a comment. I don't know that it would be a matter of course at the work session, but just to make sure that opportunity is set forth in the rules was the only one. I don't envision it necessarily being a listed agenda.
Any other questions?
Mr. Chairman, I'll make a motion we approve these changes in mass as presented by attorney.
Second. Is there any further discussion? If not, we call the motion. And that passed 4-0, Commissioner Levent being absent. We're now at the election of officers for 2013. I would like to make the motion, or I'd like to nominate Pete Amos to be the new chairman for the year.
Second.
We have a motion and we have a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote. And that passes 4-0, Commissioner Levent being absent.
Mr. Chairman, given that it was a unanimous nomination, the floor could still be open for additional nominations, but an actual motion to appoint Commissioner Amos as chairman would be in order as well.
Move that we close the nominations.
You move to close, yes, and I'll second that. If there's no further discussion, please vote. That passes 4-0, Commissioner Levent being absent. happy to turn the meeting over to you at this point if you would like.
Thank you, Mr. Boff. Appreciate it.
Well, I would like to introduce you, Commissioner Boff. I mean, it would be appropriate to go ahead and make a motion to appoint Commissioner Amos as chairman.
All right. I would make that motion to appoint Commissioner Amos as chairman.
Sir.
We have a motion and a second. If there's no discussion, please vote. That passes 4-2-0.
On the vice chairman, do we have any motion for nominations? I'd like to make a motion we nominate Jim Boff for vice chair this year.
I'm second.
Have a motion, have a second. Vote, please. Pass 4-0. Commissioner Levent absent. Is that a motion closed to nominations?
So moved.
Sir.
Please vote. That passes 4-0. Commissioner Levent been absent. Council, do we need to?
Is the motion to appoint Commissioner Boff?
Okay. Make a motion to appoint Commissioner Boff vice chairman.
Second.
Y'all please vote. Motion carries 4-0. Commissioner Levent being absent. On the secretary, do we have a motion for the nomination of secretary? I make a motion for Brian Town to fill the spot of secretary for the next year.
Second.
All in favor, please vote. Any opposed? Or Commissioner Levent, 4-0. Commissioner Levent being absent. The motion to close the nominations?
So moved.
Second.
Please vote. 4-0. Commissioner Levent being absent. Is there a motion to nominate Commissioner Town secretary?
Motion. Forgive me, Commissioner.
Yes, ma'am. I'm sorry.
So moved.
Second. Please vote. 4-0 with Commissioner Levent being absent. That takes us to announcements and reports. Do we have any announcements from the commissioners? Okay, I'd like to make an announcement about Boy Scout troop. If they would just please stand so we can all see. We are pleased to welcome Troop 211 of the Boy Scouts of America. Troop 211 is out of Cold Mountain and here tonight working on their citizenship in the community and communication badges. We welcome y'all to the meeting tonight. Appreciate you coming. Thank you. Any more announcements or reports? Public comments.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman, members of the board. We would like to take a moment to review the meeting procedures. Please silence all cell phones and electronic devices. Please refrain from disrupting the meeting through general outbursts, applause, or comments. All comments shall be directed to the entire board and not to a particular commissioner. If you have documents for the commissioners, please provide those to the clerk. If fewer than 7 copies are submitted, only 1 copy will be retained by the clerk as part of the permanent record. Those who wish to speak must sign up by completing a public comment or public hearing form available just outside this room. Information regarding specific requirements to address the board is listed at the podium. Please state that information prior to speaking. Per the county's broadcast policy, the county is not responsible for statements made during public meetings and does not warrant the accuracy of such statements. The public comments portion of the meeting is intended to allow speakers to make a verbal presentation to the board. The number of speakers is limited to 10. Speakers are selected on a first-come basis and will be heard in the order in which they sign up, with the exception that Forsyth County residents will be heard first, with non-county residents to follow until the allotted time has expired. Each speaker is limited to 3 minutes. The public comments portion is limited to 30 minutes. With respect to the public hearings portion of tonight's meeting, each side, those in opposition and those in support, are allotted 10 minutes to speak. Each speaker is limited to 3 minutes. Mr. Chairman, there are no public comment speakers signed up this evening.
Thank you, Jim. On the adoption of the minutes, the regular meeting, the public hearing of December 20th, 2012, do we have a motion to adopt these minutes?
So moved.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. Please vote. That motion carries 4-0. Commissioner Levent being absent. On to the consent agenda. Which I may say one thing, we do have a proclamation to the University of North Georgia, which we will not read tonight, and will be read in North Georgia on January 10th. So do you have a motion to adopt the consent agenda?
So moved.
Second.
Please vote. 4-0, Commissioner Levent being absent. On the public hearings, item 1A.
AL-130586, located in Mission District Number 3. This request is for approval of an alcohol license for Ken Scholl, doing business as Carnesaro Miguel. Name licensee is Ken Scholl, for an application to sell malt beverages and wine by the package at their place of business located at 6320 Atlanta Highway, Suites 3 and 4. The application is consistent with Ordinance 68.
Thank you, Tom. Is there a motion to open the public hearing?
So moved.
Second.
Please vote. Passes 4-0, Commissioner Levent being absent. Would anybody like to speak in favor of public hearing 1A, Ken Scholl? Anybody like to speak in opposition? Is there a motion to close the public hearing?
Second.
Please vote. 4-0, passes, Commissioner Levent being absent. This is District 3, Commissioner Levent's district. Staff recommends approval, Tom. All papers in order?
Everything is in order.
I make a motion that we approve Ken Soho doing business as Carnesia Miguel, name licensee is Ken Soho, to sell malt beverages, beer, and wine by the package. AL-130586.
Second.
Motion and second, please vote. Passes 4-0, Commissioner Levent being absent. 1B.
AL-130588, located in Commission District Number 2. The request is for approval of an alcohol license from Jessen LLC, doing business as TPS Pizza. Name licensee is Kyle Boyce. For an application to sell malt beverages and wine for consumption on the premises at the place of business located at 1790 B Street Parkway, Suite 212. The application is consistent with Ordinance 68.
Thank you. Is there a motion to open the public hearing?
So moved.
Second. Please vote. Motion carries 4-0. Commissioner Levent being absent. Does anyone like to speak in favor of Jefferson LLC? Anyone like to speak in opposition? Is there a motion to close the public hearing?
So moved.
Second.
All in favor, please vote. Motion carries 4-0. Commissioner Levent being absent. Commission District 2, Mr. Tam.
Yes, Mr. Chairman, it's my understanding that the application is open to order. Therefore, I move we approve the application for Jefferson LLC doing business as TBS Pizza. Name licensee is Kyle Boyce. The application to sell all beverages, beer, and wine for consumption on the premises.
We have a motion and a second. Please vote. That passes 4-0. Commissioner Levent being absent. Item 1C, Mr. Moran.
AL-130589, located in Commission District Number 3. The request is for alcohol license for Sergia LLC, DBA Pepperoni's Midway. Name licensee is Melanie Perry. For an application to sell malt beverages and wine for consumption on the premises at a place of business located at 5063 Post Road, Suites 101 and 102. The application is consistent with Ordinance 68.
Thank you, Mr. Brown. Is there a motion to open the public hearing? We have a motion and a second.
Second.
All in favor, please vote. 4-0. Commissioner Levent. Anyone not speak in favor of Sorgio's LLC doing business as Pepperoni's Midway? Anyone not speak in opposition? Chair, entertain a motion to close the public hearing.
Second.
Have a motion and a second. Please vote. 4-0. Passes. Commissioner Levent being absent. Commissioner District Number 3. Mr. Levent. All papers in order, Tom. Staff recommends approval.
Everything is in order, yes.
I make a motion we approve Sorgio's LLC doing business as Pepperoni's Midway. Name licensee is Melody Perry. The application to sell malt beverages, beer, and wine for consumption on the premises. AL-130589.
Second.
Have a motion and a second. Please vote. 4-0. Passes. Commissioner Levent being absent. On to A1D.
A013057, located in Commission District Number 1. The request is for approval of an alcohol license for Footway Retail Associates 2, limited to DBA QWRA 2, store number 208. Name licensee is Brent Cook. For an application to sell malt beverages and wine by the package at the place of business at 1295 Canton Highway. The application is consistent with ordinance number 68.
Thank you, Mr. Brown. Chair, may I entertain a motion to open the public hearing?
So moved.
Second.
Have a motion and a second. Please vote. Passes 4-0. Commissioner Levent been absent. Is anyone here like to speak in favor of Quickway Retail? Anyone like to speak in opposition? Is there a motion to close the public hearing?
So moved.
We have a motion and a second. Please vote. 4-0. Commissioner Levent being absent. This is Commission District 1, which is my district. I make a motion that we approve the Quickway Retail Associate Number 2 LTD doing business as QWRA 2, store 208. The name licensee is Brenda Cook. The application to sell malt beverages, beer, and wine by the package AL130587.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. Please vote. That carries 4-0. Commissioner Levent being absent. 1E, Mr. Brown.
AL130590, located in Commission District Number 5. This is a request for approval of an alcohol license for Nash Ham Inc. doing businesses Smart Shop 2. Name licensee is Shinaz Jisani. For an application to sell malt beverages and wine by the package at their place of business located at 1739 Buford Highway. The application is consistent with ordinance number 68.
Thank you, Mr. Brown. Is there a motion to open the public hearing? Motion second. Please vote. That passes 4-0. Commissioner Levent absent. Is anyone here to speak in favor of Napshan Incorporated? Anyone here to speak in opposition? Is there a motion to close the public hearing?
So moved.
Second. Have a motion and second. Please vote. Passes 4-0. Commissioner Levent absent. Commission District 5, Mr. Boff.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I would like to make the motion to deny application for Smart Shop 2, name licensee shown as Jisani, application to sell all beer and beverages, beer and wine by the package AL130590.
Second for discussion, please. Is that because the board?
The rest.
Yeah. Any other discussion?
Yes. It says Smart Shop 2. Do they have a Smart Shop 1 in the cabinet? Do you know?
I do not know that, sorry.
Wouldn't this the one, Mr. Buff, that was trying to change licensee at one time?
The name looks slightly familiar, but I wouldn't say it was.
And did we inform him of your decision, Tom, about denying the application?
No, we have not. This is the first time I believe we've discussed that up to this point. Our legal staff have given you a summary of the criminal history report. And this is really the first time where we actually discussed the possibility of not approving the application. So my office has not notified them of that, other than the fact that this was a hearing to determine if it would be granted.
Any other discussion? We have a motion and a second. Please vote. That carries 4-0 to deny the application. Mr. Levent been absent. Number 2, Tom.
PW130032. This is located in Commission District Number 3. This is a request for approval of a pawnbroker license for Ruben Brothers of Georgia, Inc. Brothers, name licensee is Harvey Rubin, located at 6080 Bethelview Road.
Thank you. Chair, may I entertain a motion to open the public hearing?
So move.
Motion, have a second?
Second.
Please vote. Motion carries four zero. Commissioner Levent being absent. Is anyone here this evening to speak in favor?
I can speak in favor if you wish.
Yes, sir, please come forward to the podium.
My name is Harvey Rubin. I'm the owner of Rubin Brothers in Georgia. We are a 12-year-old upscale jewelry store. Currently, we allow our customers, which total around 4,000 to 5,000, come in and sell us, besides buying the products, to sell us gold if they wish. But over the last year, since the economy, the last 2 years, since the economy has been a little sour, we have many customers who come in to sell us jewelry, but not as gold. And we can only offer them the price of gold and truly not fair for a lot of our customers. So what we'd like to do, we'd like to be able to offer them an equivalent of a pawn to loan against their upscale jewelry, but at a very low rate. Average rate today on the market, pawn shops can be anywhere between 15 and 20%. We would probably somewhere around 5% maximum, just as a service to our customers and possibly other people in the community.
Thank you, sir. Any questions? Anyone else like to speak in favor? Anyone like to speak in opposition? Is there a motion to close the public hearing?
Second.
Have a motion and a second, please vote. Motion carries 4-0. Commissioner Levent has been absent. Tim, I missed a good night.
You did.
Commissioner District 3. I make a motion that we approve the pawn shop licensee from Rubin Brothers of Georgia Incorporated, doing business as Rubin Brothers, located at 6080 Bethelview Road, Cumming, Georgia. Name licensee is Harvey Rubin, PW130032.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. Please vote. Motion carries 4-0. Commissioner Bent, being absent. On item 3.
Good evening. Before you, you have a UDC draft pertaining to church buffers and the elimination of these buffers when a religious institution abuts a residential use or residential zone property. In addition to the elimination of the buffers, we have made some minor changes to permitted uses across zoning districts when there are similar uses to a religious institution, and that includes nonprofit clubs and lodges, country clubs, private and specialized schools, and commercial recreational facilities. This is the second public hearing, so the board may choose to adopt the changes as presented or make changes. Just as a reminder, our current moratorium on these church buffers does expire the 18th of this month.
Would you do me a favor to state your name and
Vanessa Bernstein, senior planner.
We know who you are.
Thank you.
Is there a motion to open the public hearing?
So moved.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. Please vote. Motion carries 4-0. Commissioner Bent being absent. Is anyone here to speak in favor of the proposed changes to the Invite Development Code? Anyone here to speak in opposition? Is there a motion to close the public hearing?
Second.
Have a motion and a second. Please vote. Motion carries 4-0. Commissioner Levent being absent. We can take action on this tonight, Counselor?
Mr. Chairman, you can, sir.
Do we have a motion from the board?
Pleasure, board. Mr. Chairman, I'd like to make a motion that we approve the changes to the UDC regarding the elimination of undisturbed buffers in circumstances of a religious institution abuts a residential use or residentially zoned property.
Have a motion. motion, we have a second.
Second.
We have a motion and a second for approval. Please vote. Motion carries 4-0. Commissioner Levent, any announcements? Item 4.
Support carried 4. AZ120033, amendment of zoning conditions located in Commission District Number 4. The public hearings for Edward L. Smith regarding amendment of zoning condition number 22 and 23 placed on CA 2734. The request also requires a variance of Forsyth County Unified Development Code Table 11.2A for an exterior yard variance of 47 feet and a side yard variance of 7 feet. The applicant requests the conditions be amended as shown on your screen, and the property is located in the Wild Meadows Subdivision Lot 277, address 5820 Stonehaven Lane. It was zoned CR1 by the Board of Commissioners on May 28th, 2003.
Thank you, Mr. Brown. Is there a motion to open the public hearing?
So
moved. Have a motion and a second. Please vote. Motion carries 4-0. Commissioner Levent absent. Is there anyone here like to speak in favor of Edward L. Smith?
My name is Edward Smith, 5820 Stonehaven Lane, Cumming, Georgia. I'm putting a shed in the back corner of the property, and it's the only flat spot left on the property. In fact, I'm putting an 8x8 shed in, and that's the maximum size that I can put in. The other is for a pergola across the back side of my home. A 16 feet will be covered, the rest of it will be pergola.
Thank you. I guess the Homeowner Association has approved these plans.
I've got the letter of approval for the shed. They've given me a verbal approval for the porch.
Any other questions? Thank you, Mr. Smith.
Thank you.
Anyone else like to speak in favor? Anyone like to speak in opposition? Is there a motion to close the public hearing?
I'm moving.
Motion and second, please vote. The carries 4-0. Commissioner Levent been absent. Commission District 4, your first one, Cindy.
Yes.
Congratulations.
Mr. Smith. I would like to make a motion to approve the request by Edward L. Smith on AZ120033 to amend the zoning conditions placed on CA 2734 with the conditions as displayed and with a variance to the Forsyth County Unified Development Code Table 11.2A for an exterior yard variance of 47 feet and a side yard variance of 7 feet. I did go out to the property and I did speak to his neighbor, and everybody's good.
We have a motion. We have a second. Motion and second. Please vote. That passes 4-0. Commissioner Levent being absent. On to old business. Postpone 1A. 1A is postponed until January 17th. Item 2.
Old business item 2AB 120001, Carol M. Albert, located in Commission District Number 2. This was a request for appeal by Carol M. Albert regarding the acceptance of the consent order from Rockman Homes, Inc., here at AP 120001, by the Appeals Board on September 4th, 2012. The Board of Commissioners denied this appeal at their meeting on December 20th, 2012, conditioned upon Rockman Homes and Carol Albert presenting to the Board of Commissioners a signed document memorializing a settlement. This property is located on the west side of Kingsburg Shore, approximately 1,730 feet south of the intersection of Keystone Drive, and is currently zoned Res 3.
Thank you,
Tom. Mr. Chairman, members of the board, consistent with the board's directive at that last meeting where the decision was made, on December 27th, Rockman Homes did in fact tender a proposed written settlement agreement to Ms. Albert. Today, at approximately 4 p.m., Ms. Albert did respond and indicated that she had not had the opportunity to get with all the members of her
association that she was working with to decide whether those, the terms of settlement as presented by Rockland were appropriate. Therefore, there is no written settlement agreement to present to the board this evening. My respectful request to you would be, I don't read anything in the correspondence that indicates that they still cannot come to terms. What I see is that there's simply because of the holidays, there was not enough time to get consensus between the two parties. My recommendation, respectfully to the board, would be that you postpone this item until the January 8th work session and allow me to communicate to both Rockland and Ms. Nydia. The board will take this matter up at that time. If there is not a settlement agreement in place, then the board will have no choice but to otherwise go ahead and take binding action with respect to the appeal, irrespective of whether there is a compromise between the parties. Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Counselor.
I make that motion.
Second. We have a motion and a second to postpone to January 8th. Please vote. Passes 4-0. Commissioner Levent, if you have some. On the new business.
Thank you, Chairman. Today we're asking for permission to move forward with getting out the construction of the Forsyth County Animal Shelter. As you remember, this is a SPLOST 7 project. Presently, the Forsyth County Animal Control and Culture Advisory Committee has been working with the shelter planner, RTS Green, consulting for the architectural. The documents are ready and we are ready. It's only located on County Way by the Georgia State Patrol Office. At this time, again, we're just asking permitted to solicit the
Thank you. Is there a motion from the board to move ahead with the shelter?
Mr. Chairman, I'd like to make a motion that we authorize the county to issue a bid for the construction for Forsyth County on the shelter. Described by our procurement director.
We have a motion and a second. Please vote. That passes 4-0. Thank you, Doc. Item 2, County Manager.
Sir, Mr. Chairman, members of the board. Item 2 is appointment or reappointment for members of the Public Facilities Authority. This is for Commission District 2. The term of Jerry Bowman has expired. This is to the board.
Okay. Yes, Mr. Chairman, I have spoken with Mr. Bowman and he is willing to continue serving on the Public Facilities Authority Board. Therefore, I make the motion that we reappoint Jerry Bowman.
Second that motion. We have a motion and a second to reappoint Mr. Bowman. Please vote. Motion carries 4-0. Commissioner Levent being absent. Item 3.
Yes, sir, Mr. Chairman, next item, item 3, order appointments for Commission District 4. You have five in a row, A, B, C, D, and E to go through. The first one is appointment of a member to the Planning Commission. The term of Mr. Jim Kinsey has expired. These terms, as you may recall, run concurrent with Commissioner District terms. You have a bio in your agenda book for review. Chairman.
Thank you, sir. This is Commission District 4. Your motion.
Yes, I'd like to make a motion to appoint Mr. Alan Neal to the Planning Commission for District 4.
Second. I have a motion and a second to appoint Mr. Alan Neal. Please vote. Motion carries 4-0. Mr. Levent, you announce it. Number B.
B is appointment of a member of the Zoning Board of Appeals. The term of Dr. Jim Kinsey has expired. Again, there is a bio in your agenda book. Again, the term of the this appointment runs concurrent with the term of the commission. Mr. Chairman.
Thanks, sir. Commissioner District 4, Ms. Mills again.
Yes, I'd like to make a motion to appoint Ms. Bettina Hammond to the Zoning Board of Appeals for District 4.
Second. Have a motion and a second. Please vote. Passes 4-0. Commissioner Levent being absent. Number C.
C is appointment of a member of the Public Facilities Authority. The term of Paul Crager has expired. Again, this term runs concurrent with the commissioner's term, and you do have a bio in your agenda book for review. Chairman?
Thank you, sir. Commissioner?
I'd like to make a motion to appoint Charles Albert Burke Duran to the Public Facilities Authority for District 4.
Second. We have a motion and a second to appoint Mr. Duran. Please vote. Motion carries 4-0. Mr. Levent being absent. Item Item D.
D is appointment of member to the Park and Recreation Board. This is to fill the unexpired term of Charlotte Gardner. These terms are two-year terms, and I would like the county attorney to check me on this. I believe this particular appointment would be through March 21st of 2013. At that time, I believe it would come back to the board.
That sounds right. This will be a fulfillment of the remainder of the term, and then the new term will start in March.
Commissioner Spoh, one more time.
I'd like to make a motion to appoint Mr. Gary Cooper to the Park and Recreation Board to fill the unexpired term of Charlotte Gardner for District 4.
Second. Have a motion and a second to appoint Mr. Gary Cooper. Please vote. Motion carries 4-0. Commissioner Levent, be announced. Number E.
Chairman, this is appointment of member to the Keep Forsyth County Beautiful Board. You have a bio in your agenda book as well. This membership for this particular board is anywhere from 9 to 20 members. My understanding at this point, there are currently 15 members, so there is room, obviously, to appoint another member. Again, you have a bio in your agenda book for review. Mr. Chairman?
Thank you, sir. Again, District 4.
I'd like to make a motion to appoint Deborah Chambers to the Keep Forsyth County Beautiful Board for District 4.
Second. Have a motion and a second to appoint Deborah Chambers. Please vote. Motion carries 4-0. Commissioner Levent, be announced. Item 4, District 5, I believe, this time.
Yes, item 4, board appointments, reappointments. These are for Commission District 5, A, B, and C. A is for the appointment and reappointment of a member to the Planning Commission. The term of Dr. Joseph Moses has expired. This term also runs concurrent with the term of Commissioner. Mr. Chairman?
Thank you, sir. Commission District 5.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I'd like to make a motion to appoint slash reappoint Dr. Joe Moses to the Planning Commission.
We have a motion. Do we have a second?
Second.
We have a motion and a second to reappoint Dr. Moses. Please vote. Motion carries 4-0. Number B.
B, Mr. Chairman, is appointment or reappointment of a member to the Zoning Board of Appeals. The term of Deborah Bradley has expired. The term for this particular appointment runs concurrent with the term of the commission as well. Mr. Chairman?
Thank you, sir. Commission District 5, Mr. Bob.
Yeah, thank you, Mr. Chairman. I'd like to make a motion to appoint reappoint Deborah Bradley to the Zoning Board of Appeals.
We have a motion. Do we have a second? Second. We have a motion and a second to reappoint Deborah Bradley. Please vote. It carries 4-0. Commissioner Levent, be announced. Item C.
C is the appointment or reappointment of a member to the Public Facilities Authority. The term of Richard Ward has expired. Again, this term runs concurrent with the commissioner's term. Mr. Chairman?
Thank you, sir. Mr. Five again.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I'd like to make a motion to reappoint Richard Ward to the Public Facilities Authority.
We have a motion. Do we have a second?
Second.
We have a motion and a second to reappoint Mr. Richard Ward. Please vote. Motion carries 4-0. Commissioner Levent, be announced. On to administrative hearings. 1A has been postponed to February 21st. Item 1B.
Administrator and 1B, Friday next. Thank you. This is a private food cart located in Commission's District 23. This is an administrative hearing that represents a violation of the alcohol ordinance for Prior Apex Inc. doing business as Prior Food Mart at 5320 Atlanta Highway. The named employee is Amir Javid. This hearing is for the employee. In this case, this employee was issued a citation for underage sale of alcohol. The employee has no prior citations in the last 2 years. Any certified mailing was not returned to our office.
Thank you, Mr. Brown. Is there a motion to open the administrative hearing?
Second.
Got a motion and a second. Please vote. That passes 4-0. Commissioner Levent, be announced. Does anyone like to speak in favor of Jameer Jabin? Huh.
Are you?
Yeah, no, I'm not going to shove it, but.
Please come forward.
Sure.
Do you have any comments, please?
I'm going to have it now here. I'm the owner of the store, IA Vaccine, and we've been doing business since the last 14 years. And this is the first time this has happened. And I got the letter from the Forsyth County Commission's office as to the that we have never done this and commending what the county tells us to do in here.
Does this employee still work for you at this time?
Yes.
Do you know that the minimum sentence is a 30-day suspension of sales license? You cannot sell alcohol for 30 days?
Yes, I do, but I would still say that this is the first time it's happened in 14 years. So.
He's worked for you for 14 years?
He's been working with it for about 4 years.
Any other questions from the board? Thank you, sir.
Thanks.
Any questions from the deputy? Any questions? Is that motion to close the public hearing?
So moved.
Second.
Have a motion and a second. Please vote.
Some investment team doing businesses named employee is Ravel Patel. This hearing is for the employee, which the employee was issued a citation for underage sale of alcohol. The employee has no prior citations in the last 2 years, and a certified mailing was signed and returned to our office.
Thank you, Mr. Brown. Does he have a motion to open the administrative hearing? Second. Motion is second. Please vote. That passes 4-0. Commissioner Levent being absent. Is Irvin Patel in the office? Please come forward. Please state your name and address. You received a citation for underage sales?
Yeah.
I guess it was your first one and done four times, you said?
First time.
That's correct.
Any questions for the board? Do you understand the severity of this?
I know, but at this time, I'm 70 years old and the program is working. This is our high school stage, and that's why my history. I can give underage alcohol.
Are you still working the store, you said?
Yeah.
Do you understand that we have no choice but to suspend your license for 30 days at this time?
I know, but I only just need jobs. My wife is not so. My kids, one is 1 year, and one is 10 years. That's why I'm too much work.
Do you have a special date you want to start? Do you want to start tomorrow, or do you want to start?
February 1st? Yeah.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Any questions? For the deputy? The motion to close the public hearing. Administrative hearing, sorry.
So moved.
Second. There's a motion. Second, please go. Commissioner District 3, Mr. Levent.
Yes, sir. Motion that we suspend this license for 30 days starting February 1st, is that what you said?
Yes, sir.
Starting February 1st.
Second. We have a motion and a second, please. Motion carries 4-0. Commissioner Levin being absent. CII. Mr. Brown.
Located in Commission District Number 3, administrative hearing is in reference to violations of the alcohol ordinance for Sammy Investment, Inc., DBA, Sitco Quick Mark at 765 A. McFarland Parkway. Name licensee is Nazi Mali. This hearing is for the name licensee and is a follow up hearing to the one we just conducted, in which a employee was issued a citation for underage sales. The name licensee has two prior citations in the last 2 years, one for underage sales and one for an employee not having a alcohol sales ID. The certified mailing was signed and returned to our office.
Thank you, Mr. Brown. Is there a motion to open the administrative hearing?
So moved.
Second. Now, motion second, please vote. Motion carries 4-0. Commissioner Levent being absent. Is Nazim Ali present?
Yes.
You the employee that's named here?
Yes.
Lastly, I'm sorry.
Yes, sir. Sir, I've been doing business in the Forsyth County for the last 16 years. These last 2 years have been very unfortunate. As the owner of the business, I do my best to train my employees. Every time a new employee is trained, they go through at least 2 hours of training. And I have a training manual that covers everything from customer service to alcohol and tobacco training. Within the limited resources I have, I do my best to make sure that everybody is trained. On a monthly basis, I give them a refresher course on each and every topic that I have covered. This gentleman, Patel, when it happened to him, as he said that he was working 70 hours a week because he had two jobs, Kroger, and the day it happened, physically he was there, and mentally I think he was not at the store. And I apologize that happened. Since it happened with him, I sent him through another certified training for alcohol, which is a company that is endorsed by company. Recently, 2 months ago, I've also implemented a DVD training program for alcohol for all my employees. It's a 45-minute training and give them quizzes at the end of the And so as a small business owner, I mean, I'm doing my best to keep up with the law and to do whatever I have within my limited means. And it's my humble request to the commissioners to please do not suspend my license, as is the business has been very tough to keep up with the payments, and anything will probably have a very devastating effect. If you want any kind of community service that you want me to do, I'm more than willing to do that, but please do not suspend my license for you. Thank you.
Mr. Alley, do you realize that 2 underage sales in less than 2 years is a serious offense in the county?
Yes, sir, I understand. When the first offense had happened, that employee had looked at the license, he just misread. He misread the date on the license itself. And since then, I've implemented a program where they have to manually put the date of birth in the POS system. So it's the POS system that calculates the date rather than person using his brain. So I've done that on my part. Not having the license on the premises because that was his third day. My understanding of the law was that if you have another employee who has an alcohol sales license, then the second person is not supposed to have it. But I think it was verified in the last meeting when I came here. I think it was like back in August.
So you realize now everybody has to have a license?
Yes, sir. I do know that.
Any other questions from the board? Thank you, Mr. Hunt.
Thank you.
Any questions from the deputy? Is that a motion to close the administrative hearing?
Second.
Now, a motion to second, please vote. Passes 4-0. Commissioner Levent being absent. Jim, you started this, so.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I would make the motion that we suspend this license for 3 days, starting Monday.
Yes, sir. I'm fine with that. I really appreciate your 3-day fine. I mean, I'll give it that, and it's a good lesson for me, and I think it's also a good lesson for my employees that what can happen with them being irresponsible.
Yes, sir. Let me just say that the standard for this is actually a 7-day. Now, we haven't approved this yet. We still have to undergo a vote, but if you should get this 3-day and another one happens, I think you will definitely take note and probably go in another direction if there's another violation in 24 months.
Okay. I'll do my best to make sure it doesn't happen. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. We have a motion. Do we have a second? Second. We have a motion second for a 3-day suspension of the license. Please vote. Motion carries 4-0. Commissioner Lee has been absent. DI.
Administrative hearing number DI, commissioners number 1. This is administrative hearing in practice of violations of the alcohol ordinance for when you're in beverages limited, DBA Georgia Liquor Bar at 701 Atlanta Highway. Named employee has been Kate Mora Catragata. This hearing is for the employee. The employee was issued a citation for underage sale of alcohol. Employee has no prior citations in the last 2 years. The certified amount was signed and returned to our office.
Thank you, Tommy. Is there a motion to open the administrative hearing?
So moved.
Second.
Have a motion second. Please vote. Motion carries 4-0. Commissioner Levent being absent. Is Mr. Vintesa right?
Vintesa. My name is Vintesa. Copy of that?
Yes, sir. Please.
And that mistake, sorry.
Do you still work at this establishment?
Yes,
do you realize that the minimum for employees is a 30-day suspension of license? We can make it effective now, make it effective middle of January or February, 1st of February. What would you like to have the suspension start?
Tomorrow.
For 30 days, you cannot sell alcohol. You still work, but you cannot sell any alcohol products. Any other questions from the board? Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
Any questions from the deputy? Is there a motion to close the administrative hearing?
Second.
Have a motion second. Please vote. Passes 4-0. District 1. I make a motion to suspend Mr. Vinkesawa's license for 30 days starting tomorrow.
Second.
Is that all right? You had time? Have a motion and a second. Please vote. Motion carries 4-0. Commissioner Levent being absent. DII.
Commission District Number 1, this is an administrative hearing in reference to violations of the alcohol ordinance for Beer and Beverages Limited, DBA Georgia Liquor Bar at 701 Atlanta Highway. Name licensee is Sharita Katragata. This hearing is for the name licensee. It's the follow-up hearing to the one we just conducted, in which an employee was issued a citation for underage sale of alcohol. The name licensee has two prior citations, one for having drink specials and one for consumption on the premises. The certified manual was signed and returned to our office.
Thank you, Tom. Is there a motion to open the administrative hearing?
So moved.
Second.
Have a motion and a second. Please vote. Motion carries 4-0. Commissioner Levent being absent. Mr. Siddhar?
Yeah.
Please state your name and address.
I'm Steve Katragata. 701 Atlanta Highway, Georgia.
Thank you, sir. Tom, what's a drink special with it?
Yeah, why not?
It's a happy hour. Mm-hmm. Don't know that.
Okay, so that's what he was having, a happy hour?
Closest to that section of our ordinance is typically called the happy hour section when just talking about it casually. And it was a violation of that drink special. It didn't conform to the regulations of the alcohol ordinance.
Okay.
And that was in the past. That was the one of the prior citations.
Yes, sir.
Yes, thank you.
Have you done something to correct these underage sales?
We took the training classes from the one of the instructor on the front of the schools. And regarding the citations, when we opened the white tasting room, one of the employees, he took advertisement that he drinks specials ad in the group fund. In the internet, the Groupon internet website. So immediately, in the first 1 hour in the morning, the cop came in and gave us the citation ticket, like a warning letter. And he immediately took it out from the Groupon. But we did not really sell it to anybody. Mm-hmm. And
this is your third violation in less than 24 months. Do you realize that? This is more serious every time with the violation. So please help us correct it.
Sorry.
Any other questions from the board?
I just don't understand how you're having a happy hour at the Georgia Liquor Bar.
Yeah, when we start the wine tasting room, the employee put a coupon in the group bar website. So the cop came in the first thing in the morning. He told you should not do that and gave us a warning letter. And we did not really conduct the program. It's just on the internet and we took it up in the first 1 hour itself.
This, Commissioner Tam, this name licensee actually has two outlets, two separate outlets. One is a package liquor store. One is a cigar store that sells alcohol for consumption.
Is that what a happy hour was conducted at?
Yes.
That's
great. That's confusing. I was lucky for an hour. I was happy. I had happy hour at the lip store. Okay. Any other questions?
The drinking on the premises, what happened? That's the first citation. What happened was one of the vendors, they left the open wine bottle in the store. We still did not have the license for the wine tastings at that time. So then when we got inspected, they gave us a citation, but nobody really consumed the wine. We had an open wine bottle in the store. So we asked the vendor to come to the court. We also went to the court. But since then, the vendor disappeared. We actually supplied the wine for us.
Do you understand all the rules and regulations now, wine tasting?
Yes, sir.
Do you know how to perform it?
Yes, sir.
Tom, since he has two stores, if we suspend his license, does it apply to both stores or just a store?
He has one license, does it not?
Yes.
He has two separate licenses.
He has two separate
licenses. He has a license for each outlet.
In his name?
He's the name licensee for each outlet, yes.
But the happy hour was at the cigar bar.
That's right. When we present these, we have always historically presented you all violations under that individual's name, regardless of the outlet location. And what I've seen the board historically do is make if there's any kind of warning letter or suspension, apply it. Typically, we see that applied just to the outlet of the most recent infraction.
Okay, that's what I'm not sure. So, which can apply to the store that had the infraction on these sales.
So I've seen in the past, yes.
Any other questions? Thank you, sir. The motion to close the administrative hearing.
Mm-hmm.
Second. Have a motion and second, please vote. So this happened at the Georgia Liquor Bar. This last citation. I make a motion to place a warning letter in the liquor license of Georgia Liquor Bar located at 701 Atlanta Highway. And this is a warning letter, so if it happens again, it's going to get tougher.
Sure, thank you.
Have a motion to have a second. Please vote. Motion carries 4-0. At that time of day. Ken?
Mr. Chairman, we do need an executive session. We will not be coming back out of executive session to go back to the open session, except to adjourn that we have substantive action taken. But Mr. Chairman, I do need an executive session for purposes of land acquisition, personnel, and litigation.
Okay. We have a motion to recess to regular meeting.
Mm-hmm.
Have a second?
Second.
Please vote. Vote carries 4-0. Commissioner Levent passes. We will have executive session in 10 minutes. Start 6:17.
I didn't turn my microphone on for quite a while. Jody came over and said, "Miss Mills, you haven't turned on your mic yet. Did you notice I left it on?" That's what Pete does. Pete does that. She told me that when I came and actually practiced. And so I just left it on from then on out. Well, thank you. Thank you so much. Stay in touch. Thank you.
It makes a lot of sense. Prove them right, prove that I can do a good job as chairman. I'm willing to listen and willing to take any comments. Yes, I'll attach you, just run a good program and get it done.
Looking ahead to the new year, what do you feel like would be some of the biggest challenges to life? You got lost behind you, you got the jail coming up. Do you see any other new challenges coming?
Well.
Okay, it won't be long. Bye.
I'm going to. Good job.
Did you see Alan? Did y'all see Alan?
He sat on the end. I didn't get to speak to him.
Alan Neal, he was back there, but then he. You did. He'll do a good job.
So what's Charlotte? Did she resign?
Yeah, she had resigned when I did. And then Patrick asked her to fill in my.
Yeah.
And then so she had sent, she actually sent me an email like in December saying, I'm ready, I'm ready, I'm ready.
She did.
That's all again in March.
You do. Thank you. Thank you.
Good job.
First meeting's the 8th, right? That's what I.
Yes. And just let me know how it goes. Deborah, let me know if I need to do anything. Thank you.
Any meetings we need to do, let me know. If you want updates and stuff.
Okay. Yeah, just call me.
Will do.
Okay, thank y'all.
Thanks for the coffee. I'm your lifesaver.
Nydia, Gary, turn the camera on Nydia and ask her how she's feeling about being the sole, about Forsyth person with Milam retiring. With the camera.
Big responsibility, big shoes to fill.
Yes.
He supported me in this meeting, being chairman. I supported him as vice chairman. I look forward to working with him. I look forward to asking him for his knowledge of being chairman of the year. And also, Mr. Cannon.
You have a good evening too.
This whole time.
Absolutely.
You have got to be kidding me.
I don't want to miss a single moment.
Don't you run out of film?
Oh, Jimmy.
Not with this digital.
I think if we vote, we'll still have to push that button.
Is there a motion to adjourn the regular meeting? So moved. Have a second?
Second.
All in favor, vote. Motion carries 4-0. We stand adjourned.
If I should happen to sit there, it's not out of being pompous, it's out of habit. Like,
I remember that.
Yeah.
Have a good evening. See ya. Thank you.
Bye. I like how you strike the gavel, Chairman Amos. You must know how to throw a hammer.
I can throw a hammer. What, is she filming you walking out, Ken?
This is the dramatic shot.
The dramatic shot? Yeah. Ken's little bit.
Danny Wall. Maybe.
Good night.
Good night.
Here, huh? I couldn't miss the chairman's first gavel strike. Good night, John. Thank you.